What am I doing?
So I got this King Kong poster printed in 3 sheets. It's a lithographically printed poster, but it's actually a recreation of the original Kong poster from the 1930s, which was probably printed in offset. This one, an artist did a lithographic interpretation of that poster, and it was printed on very beautiful, heavy, acid-free paper. So this print is from the early 2000s, and it's just remarkable. It actually looks much better, probably, than the poster from the 30s, because this printing is so good. However, it's got the original logo of the Morgan Litho Company on it. And this probably implies that it's a reproduction. So we're going to linen back it to put it together. It's the only way it can be seen. But first we have to prepare a screen. I kind of doubt there's overlap, but we'll find out when we put it in the second piece down. You can take spray. So I believe this poster was printed in 1997. It came with a certificate of authenticity, which I will read to you now. King Kong, this fine art lithograph is a remastered work of multiple fine art, which was produced at the prestigious S2 Editions Atelier, New York City, in 1997, under the auspices of the Ray Society Limited and S2 Art Company. It is based upon a vintage poster first printed in 1933. The artist is unknown. Pulled on 3 sheets of Reeves BFK handmade paper, one color at a time from separate plates, this lithograph has been sequentially numbered in pencil in the lower left corner by a curator at S2 Editions. The noted American chromist David Copson recreated the image in 1997 by hand drawing directly onto specially prepared surfaces that were transferred onto lithographic plates, one plate for each color. The resulting lithograph is in pure color without the dot structure which occurs in the photographic process of modern offset printing. King Kong was printed on a 19th century French-made Marinoni Warin press under the supervision of the atelier's technical director, Raymond Mazza. The overall paper size of the three lithographs is 41.5 by 83 inches, the same size as the vintage poster. This lithograph bears the trademark of the Ray Society, plus the blind stamp emblem of the S2 Editions Atelier. The signature of the chromist, David Copson, is also printed unobtrusively on this lithograph. And then there's more on this certificate, talking about the virtuoso animation of Willis O'Brien dazzled the audiences when King Kong premiered in 1933. And it depicts the most memorable scene in the film, one of the most remembered images in movie history. The few King Kong vintage posters of this image that are known to have survived are in very bad condition due to folds, tears, and paper deterioration. Yet, in spite of bad condition, auction prices for this image exceed $100,000. This King Kong lithograph is in perfect condition and is printed on three sheets exactly the size and the way the original movie poster was printed in 1933. I want to tell you that on Saturday, October 19th, at 12 noon to 5 p.m., the Brooklyn Navy Yard is open to the public. You can come in if you register with OHNY. You can come in and visit businesses that are participating in the open house. PosterFix is one of those businesses. So bring your friends over to the Navy Yard, visit the Navy Yard, have lunch here in Building 77, and visit PosterFix.